I'm going to show you how to turn a oversized t-shirt into a dress. I'm going to be using the shirt. This is an extra large, I think. Yeah, this is an extra large Krizz Kaliko Kicking and Screaming tee. Awesome album. Get it at strangemusicgang.net. Okay. So to start out, sorry this is going to be upside down for the camera. If you have never done this before, you might want to practice on a shirt that you don't care about first, because you really don't want to mess up a great shirt. So as I said, this shirt is an extra large, and obviously I'm not an extra large. So we're going to have to take a generous amount off. Okay, so start at the bottom. Make a straight line, obviously. And once you get to the arm, you don't want to stop there, because then you're going to have huge arms. So I have pretty skinny arms, so I'm going to go up pretty high. Okay, so here's the sleeve right here. I cut it to here, so my sleeve will be right about here. So that would be pretty fitted to my arm, and you want it to be a little smaller than your arm, that way your lace will show. So if not, you're going to have to tie it like really tight, and you won't even really see the lace, and yeah, that'd be just be stupid. Okay, so now we're going to do the same thing for the other side. You should have something that looks like this, and what you want to do is, where you stopped cutting on the side, you want to cut a straight line up to the end of the sleeve. So lay it back out flat. Get everything lined up again. And we're going to cut a straight line right here, and this is going to be our new sleeve. Do the same thing to the other side. And you can already see this looks way smaller, and we have some quarter sleeves on our dress. So now what we want to do, put this aside for a second, we want to take another shirt. This is just a random shirt. It looks better if it's a different color than the shirt you are going to have as your dress. You don't really want your lace to be the same color, because it won't really pop as much. So I'm going to use this, which I wanted black, but I can't find an old black shirt. So this is like a really dark gray. It's close enough. No one's really going to know. So line up the seams the best you can. The bottom. And you just want to cut the seam straight off, because we're not going to use that part. Get it all straightened out again. Okay, now what we're going to do is cut strips. But we're not going to cut all the way to the end. You're going to leave about an inch. You don't want to cut them really, really thin, because they'll rip. So you want to at least an inch minimum. Okay, so go ahead and cut your strips. Okay, so leave about this much at the top. Don't cut that. Okay, so I cut a whole bunch. I wasn't counting as I went. But you're going to want about 6 to 7. Okay, so take this 7 right here, and you're just going to want to cut that off. You want to take each of these individually, and you want to stretch them. This gives them more of a round, like they kind of curl up, so they look more, just look better. Okay, so now it should look like this. I'm going to take straight down the middle. This is what it should look like. Okay? So, I'm going to go to one side. I'm going to take the first strip, and we're going to make a cut over. My scissors suck. Okay, we're going to make a cut over to the edge. So this brings it down and leaves it like as one. And then we flip it over. So it's on this side still, okay? And we make a straight cut from this to this. And then cut it right off. Okay? So then that drops down. So it connects further. So you have this much already. So we flip it over and just keep doing that. Just basically make sure whenever you flip it over, the part that's like all one string is towards you. So then you just cut straight up into the other one. This is really confusing and I'm not good at explaining things, so hopefully you kind of understand what I'm saying. Okay, so after you've done all that, you should have an extremely long string, just like this. So now you want to take your shirt, lay it back out, make sure everything's lined up again. I'm just going to take my scissors and you just got to stab some holes in it. And when you punch the holes, you want to go like back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Because if you just go like straight up, it's harder to line it up on this side. And you want to make sure you have an even amount on each side. Also, when you punch your holes, you don't want to punch them like this close. You want to leave yourself like about this much room, maybe like an inch. Make sure you have the front and the back together, so you're punching through both sides. You want to try to make them about like 2 inches apart. So just kind of eyeball it. You don't really have to measure this stuff out. I don't. So then you can just jam your scissors through. There we go. Now go on this side, do the same thing. Try to eyeball it. Jam it through. So now we're going to do the same thing to the sleeves. So make sure this is lined up right here. Okay, now make holes all the way up to the end of your sleeve, including the seam. So once you got all your holes punched, lay it out on one side, and you're going to start at the sleeve, because we want the ends to be at the bottom of your shirt on the side, so you can tie it there. So now you just lace it up just like you would a shoe. So I'll go ahead and I'm going to do that one side and I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. So I finished my first side and this is what it looks like. You can kind of see the way it's going to look. So there's that one side. Now, I got to the bottom and I did not tie it because I want to finish lacing up the other side first. And then adjust it because I might have laced it, you know, a little too tight or too loose or whatever. So you want to just leave these hanging until you get the other side finished and then adjust it so it fits you right and then go ahead and tie it off. So I'm going to go ahead and lace up my other side and I will show you the finished product.
This is the trip. The best part I really, really like. Yeah, I'm proud to be a part of this number. Hey, yo, Cali, kill him.
Cali, baby, no, we claim we insane. Say it's strange, it's the same thing. Drain the main vein, don't make. extremes, they plain Jane. Tell them when to get off, tell them knock it off.
Mine, mine.
Tell them if they're pissing, pick them off.
Like a prime time.
Coming out the middle is the reason we don't took so long. Give them just a little when they do it to my song. I make it do a song, sing it to you a song. Fluids get moving in the middle with pillars and chewing on. Other rappers ain't compatible, they be fallible. If you wanna challenge me, battle, we better saddle up. I'm with a man of love, send them back paddling, paddling, tattling, tattling, rattle them till they had enough. And like old liquor, Kaliko, speak easy, be easy. If I liquor, Kaliko, freak easy. You're crazy, little shit, they're like a PE, only see.